Hello and welcome back to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today we're going to see the end user settings options within the security module of a Scriptcase. Alright, so here we go. We need to create a first security module. So we need to go to the modules menu and then security. I'm going to have that we'll use the group's security type and I'm going to hit next here. Okay, so I will use the standard settings here and then we can go ahead. During this process, Scriptcase created a bunch of tables. You can see here at this screen where Scriptcase actually save your information, your settings, and all the things related with the security module. So this is nothing new, but right here you can see two new tables that are going to be created within your database. The first one is the two-factor authentication, which we have a specific video talking about that. Please check the description. And the other one is the picture. So from now on, you can use this field and create a menu using this picture, or maybe you can use it in different parts of your final system. So I'm going to head by clicking next here. And right now we have all the standard security settings. And we have a specific field called settings. Once we enable this option, the final user can actually change different parts of the settings of the security module that until now, only the developer can change that. So we're going to give some permissions for the admin of the final system in order to change that. So I have a security module here I just created. And as you can see here, we have all these options. So we need to go to the settings menu. So right now we can see all the options. So let's talk about them, all right? So the very first option we can see here is the session expiration action. And we have a couple of options here. So we can select here no action or redirect to the login. Then we have the remember me option. And then we have here how many days we're going to save our credentials. Then we have here the option for retrieve the password. We can also enable external users to create a new user within your system. Then we have here the brute force options. We have the minutes and the attempts. And finally, we have here the two-factor authentication. All right, and how you can upload that picture for your final user? Well, it's pretty simple. You just need to go to the users menu. Then we are going to see all these pictures. I've been uploading here some images as you can see here, but you can do it by yourself by clicking here at add new and just select here your image. All right, so thank you all for watching, and if you liked the tutorial, please thumbs up.